Hi there. Have you ever wondered whether filters like circular polarizers or neutral density would be useful for super telephoto lenses and wildlife photography? Well, for some time, I've wanted a filter kit that includes these and that works with my Sony 200-600. But that's been difficult to find. And so I was really pleased when Freewell reached out to me and asked me if I'd try their kit, which I'm pleased to share with you today. Now, Freewell have provided me a kit to try, but I'm receiving no payment for this whatsoever, and any views or opinions that I give you are entirely my own. So let's crack on. Some ducks. So I'm at this pond and there's lots and lots of different kinds of birds on it. And what I'm going to do is try to get photos of them with a slower shutter speed. So I'm talking less than maybe about 1/80th of a second, hopefully even down to as much as 1/20th. And what I'm doing for this is using the stops filters. And I'm going to start at 6 stops. And the great thing about these stops filters is that they have got a hard stop when you turn them. So I can be at 9 and then I switch to 6 and it doesn't let me go any further, and I can move back to 9 and everything in between. But I'm going to start out with the 6 stop on, and that's because it's in the middle of the range. If I find that I need a little bit more, I might go higher, or if I need a little bit less, I might switch to the 2-5 stop filter. And all I'm going to do is expose as I normally would, but based upon that slow shutter speed. So I'm going to start out with about 1/50th of a second. What I want to do is try and pan with the bird as it's flying. So I've got to follow the bird's direction as it flies across the sky or up into the sky. And if I maintain the same speed and using a slow shutter speed, I should be able to get some really nice blur in the wings. But not only that, I should be able to blur out the background. And that can be useful in a number of scenarios, one of which is when your background is closer to your subject than you would really want. Egret.
It's not easy though. You'll find that you sometimes misfocus or don't pan at the right speed, or both. It's harder the smaller the bird is.
Oh, kingfisher. Wow, out of the blue, kingfisher. I don't think I got it, but let's have a look.
But when it all comes together, you get something that gives you a real sense of motion and can feel a little more like a painting than a photo.
Okay, so now I'm comfortable that I've got my setup right, I've got my panning technique right, which, by the way, what I'm doing is having my feet at right angles to each other, keep some stability, and I'm turning from my waist rather than from my neck, and that's giving me a lot smoother motion. Just thought it's worth explaining why I'm going handheld rather than using my tripod and gimbal head. As many of you who watch this channel regularly will know, I love using my tripod or a monopod with my gimbal head, but that is to give me the stability to have as low a shutter speed as I can get away with. In this case, I've got really low shutter speed anyway, so I don't need it. So this just gives me a little bit more flexibility than using some stability like a monopod or a tripod.
The aim here is to track the bird's head and to try and have that in focus or as close to focus as possible, whilst allowing everything else to be unfocused and blurred.
Thank you. So for a first attempt with these filters, I think that was really useful. In less than 3 hours, I got a good handful of shots that have managed to pull off the effect that I'm looking for. And I think with a bit more practice and time getting used to these filters, I'll be able to do that more successfully, more regularly. Now, I'm going to go on and show you some footage from this morning where I was testing the capabilities of the circular polarizer. But before that, let's find out a little bit more about this filter kit. Now, the reason that I've struggled to find a filter kit for my super telephoto lens is because it's got a 95mm filter thread at the front end. And not many manufacturers make filters that size. In fact, I'm only aware of one other kit on the market that fits this filter thread size. And actually, it's a filter thread size that's really popular with lots of lenses that you would see used in wildlife photography. So not just the Sony 200-600, the Nikon 500mm, and the third party zooms like the Sigma and Tamron 150-600mm, they all use 95mm filter threads. And the other kit that is on the market only contains 4 filters. So if I wanted to have the sheer amount of filters that are in the Freewell kit, I'd have to spend hundreds and hundreds of pounds more on buying extra filters. And then it would take up a lot of space in my camera bag to carry all of that stuff around. Now, the Freewell filter kit is made up of just 4 pieces of glass and 1 base ring, so it comes in a really tiny package. And what makes it so versatile is that you combine those pieces of glass in different ways, and 2 of them are reversible. So what you actually get with the Freewell kit is a 2-stop to 5-stop ND, a 6-stop to 9-stop ND, a circular polarizing filter, a mist filter, and mist with 2 to 5 stops and 6 to 9. So that gives you a total of 20 filters. And the price of that is just £50 more than that other kit that I mentioned where you only get 4 filters. So less space in the camera bag, better value for money. This kit sounds like it could be the one for me. One problem that I often encounter when photographing birds that have been on or in water in bright light is that the water can reflect that light and blow out some of their plumage. And I find this often with waterfowl and with things like kingfishers. So I'm down here at this pond, which has got lots of swans, and I'm going to use the swans to test the capabilities of this circular polarizing filter to reduce some of the reflected light and help me avoid blowing out the plumage. Hello, Swanny. Hello. So first, I'm not trying to get nice photos here. I'm purely doing this as a test. I don't want to spend my time today photographing swans. I've got other things I need to get to. But as a test for the polarizer, I'm going to take some photos to start with without the polarizer on, just after the swans have dipped their head in the water and they've still got lots of water droplets on them. And I'm going to just simply try and get a decent exposure.
So here is a simple shot of a mute swan. I've exposed it so that none of the blacks are crushed, as you can see here in the histogram for this image. Next, I put the CPL filter on and got an image of the same swan in the same position relative to the light. For this to be a fair comparison, I needed to ensure that the blacks were not crushed, just avoiding touching the left-hand side of the histogram. So let's compare images. The natural whiteness of the swan's feathers are translucent against that bright sunlight, meaning that the wing feathers were bright, but all the detail is still present in both images. Around the swan's head and neck, though, it is even brighter. Swans dip their head and neck in and out of the water a lot, and on this swan, the water is reflecting so much light that there's no apparent detail there. But if we look at the histogram for both images, you'll see that the one without a filter is peaking at the right-hand side, meaning that the whites are blown out. The histogram for the photo with the CPL filter isn't blown out to the same extent. Sometimes those blown out whites are recoverable from the raw file, so let's drop the exposure by 2 stops for both images. In the image with no filter, those whites are still blown out. However, in the one with the filter, the detail is all still there. The filter has reduced the glare of the reflected light by enough to make the whites recoverable. This means I can balance the tones a little more in Lightroom to get a workable image. So this CPL filter is going to massively help me with photographing birds that are in and around water. Let's have a look at how the kit fits together. Firstly, you have to remove the lens hood because you can't fit a lens hood with filters attached, but this is the same for all threaded filters. I didn't experience any lens flare all day, even though I didn't have a lens hood on and I was often shooting into direct sunlight. Next, you attach the base ring by screwing it into the filter thread. Now you can magnetically attach one of those base filters, either the one-stop ND or the mist, by matching the Freewell logo on the filter to the logo on the base ring. Then you can add a variable filter, either ND or CPL, magnetically over the top of it. Match the letter A on the filter with A on the base ring. You can remove or change the filters quickly and easily without having to unscrew anything. It also has a magnetic lens cap, which you can attach with the logo facing outwards over a base filter or inwards over a variable filter. And that's because of the polarity of the magnets.
So a few other features that you might be interested in. Freewell calls these the world's first versatile variable ND filters. And I would have to agree, the fact that you get the function of 20 filters out of just 4 makes them incredibly versatile. As well as that, they claim that they are waterproof and scratch resistant. Now, I can't talk about waterproof today because of the conditions, but certainly scratch resistant. I've dropped the 6-to-9-stop filter 4 times so far today, and it's not got a scratch on it. All I've done is dusted it off with a lens tissue, and it's been absolutely fine. Now, as well as that, it comes in this rather nice case. Now, I'm not going to talk about the design. I'm not into that kind of thing. You'll never see a review from me that talks about how premium something looks. Those cliches can go in other people's reviews. For me, it's all about function. And this is a really useful functional case. So all of the filters are in there. It's only about 3 centimeters wide, so it doesn't take up much space in your camera bag. And it's got this little cord that you pull, and they all pop out for easy access. So I found that a really useful thing to be able to get to these filters when I've needed them throughout the day. So we're not far off the end of the day. It's a couple of hours till sunset, and I've got a little walk to go to get to the pond where I want to be photographing some birds in those sunset colours to test the capabilities of that mist filter. So I'm at a lovely pond now with lots of birds, and there's about an hour till sunset. So few opportunities for me to get some photos. I've got the mist filter on, and I'll take some shots with and some without, and then we can compare.
So I started trying to take photos of the gulls and wanted 2 photos where the birds were in the same position relative to the sun. But the gulls just weren't as cooperative as the swans were earlier. So just for the testing part, I took photos of the scenery around me. Here is a photo with no filter. You've got reeds in the foreground glowing in those sunset colours. There's some bushes and trees in the background with the sky. Just outside of the frame to the right is the sun. Here's the same scene with the same camera settings, but with the addition of a mist filter. You can immediately see it's nicer, so let's take a look at why. Firstly, the reeds. You can see reduced contrast. The highlights aren't so bright and the shadows aren't so dark, but they're still glowing, just glowing in a different way. Next, the out-of-focus background tree. Again, there's a reduction in contrast that's much more pleasing. And finally, the bushes in the sky. There's a slight reddish tint in the shadow areas, which is nice for sunset shots, and a reduced contrast, meaning that it isn't blown out in the white areas of the sky in the same way that it is without a filter. So now that I understand the effect the mist filter is having, I know exactly how I'm going to use it to get some nice pictures, and that is with backlit silhouettes of waterfowl.
So it's been a few days now since I spent that day testing the Freewell Variable Magnetic ND filter kit, and I've had plenty of chance to check out all the photos from that day, and I have to say overall I am really impressed, so much so that I'm going to start using these filters for my landscape and woodland photography as well. I do have a filter kit that works with those lenses, and it's not as good as these variable ND filters from Freewell. And part of that is because it's such a pleasurable experience to use these. They're magnetic, they clip straight on, it's not fiddly, you're not having to screw things in and out. It's just such a nice experience to use. Another thing I want to mention about variable ND filters is that generally they get a bit of a bad reputation, and that's because of the so-called kiss of death, a sort of black cross that is across your frame at certain points in the rotation of those filters. But that does not exist at all from what I've seen with this Freewell kit, so I was really pleased to see that. And the only real downside I can find from them is that it's so easy to knock off the filters being magnetic. So I mentioned earlier that I dropped them a few times, and that was where I was carrying my camera and lens down by my leg, brushed it up against my leg and knocked the filter off. So I just need to think about changing that behavior when I'm out and about using these filters on my super telephoto lens. Now, if you're interested in buying this kit, all the links are in the description below and you can get them on Amazon, or you can check out freewellgear.com for more information. I have found one additional usage for these filters, and that's creating abstract pictures. During the course of the day, I found a number of abstract photos, and these were entirely serendipitous. But now I'm thinking, what if I put my mind to going out and purposefully creating abstract wildlife photos? So that may be something that you see at some point in the future. If you're interested in learning more about abstract photography and want to see a video where abstract saved the day, check out this video here. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.